forward, right, forward, right, forward, left, backward, backward, left, forward. Hey everyone, we're back with another dive into some speech recognition. In the last video, we built our very own Alexa using wake word detection running on the ESP32. Marvin, tell me a joke.
What goes up and down but does not move? Stairs.
The actual processing of the user's request is performed by a service called WIT AI, which takes speech and converts it into an intention that can be executed by the ESP32. In this video, we're going to do some limited voice recognition on the ESP32 itself and build a voice-controlled robot. Once again, we'll be using the command dataset as our training data. I've selected a set of words that would be suitable for controlling a small robot: left, right, forward, and backward. We'll train up a neural network to recognize these words and then run that model on the ESP32 using TensorFlow Lite. We're going to be able to reuse a lot of the code from our previous video with some minor modifications. Let's have a quick look at generating our training data. We have our standard set of imports and some constants. In a departure from our previous Alexa work, we're going to split the words into two sections: command words and nonsense words. We'll train our model to recognize the command words and reject the nonsense words and background noise. We have a set of helper functions for getting the list of files and validating the audio, and we have our function for extracting the spectrogram from the audio data. Once again, we're going to augment our data. We'll randomly reposition the word within the audio segment, and we'll add some random background noise to the word. To get sufficient data for our command words, we'll repeat them multiple times. This will give our neural network more data to train on and should help it generalize. A couple of the words, forward and backward, have fewer examples, so I've repeated these more often. For our nonsense words, we won't bother repeating them as we have quite a few examples. As before, we'll include background noise, and we'll also include the same problem noises we identified in the previous project. With the training data generation completed, we just save it to disk. And here's some examples of the words in their spectrogram format. In our previous project, we just trained to recognize one word. We'll now want to recognize multiple words. Once again, we have our usual includes, and we have a list of the words that we want to recognize. We load up our data, and if we plot a histogram, we can see the distribution of words. Ideally, we'd have a bit more of a balanced dataset, but having more negative examples may actually help us. We have a fairly simple convolutional neural network with two convolution layers, followed by a fully connected layer, which is then followed by our output layer. As we are trying to recognize multiple different words, we use the softmax activation function, and we use the categorical cross entropy as our loss function. I do have a couple of introductory videos on TensorFlow that explain these terms in a bit more detail. After training our model, we get just under 92% accuracy on our training data and just over 92% accuracy on our validation data. Our test dataset gives us similar levels of performance. Looking at the confusion matrix, we can see that it's mostly misclassifying our words as invalid. This is probably what we'd prefer, as ideally we'd like to err on the side of false negatives instead of false positives. Since we don't appear to be overfitting the model, I've trained it on the complete dataset. This gives us a final accuracy of around 94%, and looking at the confusion matrix, we do see a lot better results. It is possible though that we are now might be overfitting, but let's try it in the real world. For that, we're going to need a robot. I'm going to build a very simple two-wheeled robot. We're going to use two continuous servos and a small power cell. We'll need to give it quite a wide wheelbase, as the breadboard with the ESP32 on it is quite large. After a few iterations, I've ended up with something that looks like it will work. To assemble it, it's pretty straightforward. We just need to bolt the two servos onto the chassis and attach the wheels. The breadboard just sits on top of the whole contraption. Let's have a look at the firmware. We have some helper libraries. The TF micro library contains all the TensorFlow Lite code. We have a wrapper around that to make it slightly easier to use. This library contains the trained model exported as C code, along with a helper class to run the neural network prediction. We then have our audio processing. This recreates the code that we used when we generated the training data. This processes a 1 second window of samples and generates the spectrogram that will be used by the neural network. Finally, we have our audio input library. This will read samples either from the internal ADC for analog microphones or from the I2S interface for digital microphones. In the main application code, we have the setup function, which creates our command processor and our command detector. The command detector is run by a task that waits for audio samples to become available and then services the command detector. Our command detector rewinds the audio data by 1 second, gets the spectrogram, and then runs the prediction. To improve the robustness of our detection, we sample the prediction over multiple audio segments and also reject any detections that happen within 1 second of a previous detection. If we detect a command, then we queue it up for processing by the command processor. Our command processor runs a task that listens on this queue for commands. When a command arrives, it changes the PWM signal being sent to the motors to either stop them or set the required direction. To move forward, we drive both motors forward. For backwards, we drive both motors backward. For left, we reverse the left motor and drive the right motor forward. And for right, we do the opposite. Right motor reverse and left motor forward. With our continuous servos, a duty cycle of 1500 microseconds should hold them stopped. Lower than this should reverse them, and higher should drive them forward. I've slightly tweaked the values for the right motor forward value, as it was not turning as fast as the left motor, and this caused the robot to veer off to one side. Note that because we have the right motor upside down, to drive it forward, we actually run it in reverse, and to drive it backward, we run it forward. You may need to calibrate some of these values for your own motors to get the robot to go into a straight line. So that's the firmware code. Let's see the robot in action again. Left. Right. Forward. Backward. Right. Right. Forward. Backward. Left. Left. Right. How well does it actually work? Reasonably well. It's a nice technology demonstration and a fun project. It does occasionally confuse words and mix up left and right. It's got a mind of its own, and it will just start wandering around if you don't talk to it.
Crazy. You mean this thing just runs by itself?
Thing? An object without life? A personal possession? Incorrect. Johnny Five, not a thing.
Yeah, right. But I mean...
We're starting to reach the limits of what's really possible. We have a limited amount of RAM to play with, and the models are starting to get very big. We also have a limited amount of CPU to play with. The larger models take longer to process, making real-time detection harder. Having said that, there are a lot of improvements that can be made. So, thanks for watching. I hope you found this video useful and interesting. Please subscribe if you did. All the code's on GitHub. Let me know how you get on in the comments. See you in the next video.